Hi, and welcome back to another episode of the History of Fan Anime. I'm your host, William Chow. Today is another exciting episode where I'm going to announce some more items for the anime giveaway part 4. Okay, so this is the third episode of goodies and that kind of stuff that I'm offering out to the viewers out there, trying to get some anime merchandise and kind of give back to the community, okay? So again, if you haven't seen episode 1 and 2, you might want to take a look at those and see some of the goodies that are available. I will give you the shipping instructions in the next episode. So, keep a list of or things of what you want. Gonna probably do a kind of a 1, 2, 3, 4 type of idea where it's your first, second, and third choices sort of thing, and then we're gonna queue it up against all the people who are subscribers and supporters for the channel. So again, I have a special channel. Also dedicated towards the subscribers and the supporters of the History of Fan Anime. Okay, these people have basically have access to the special episodes. I've just finished updating those episodes and all the links. So now that all the links are now on a private server, and you should have access. And again, if you didn't get an email or whatever about those, contact me and I'll read up you update those for you. In the meantime, don't forget to click like and click subscribe. And if it's kind of on the fence about wanting to donate something or get onto the Patreon or get onto the PayPal for a subscription, this might be a good time to do it because there's a lot of goodies here, and if you're on that list, you do get first access on all of the stuff above everybody else, okay? So just keep that in mind. All right, so what kind of goodies have we got this time? So again, I've gotten a whole bunch of a little different things throughout when I was running my store, when I was going to conventions and kind of stuff, and I have a bunch of extra stuff which I'm making available to you guys, because again, I think one of the things that's missing in the modern day sort of anime and that kind of stuff in the field today is that people are just lacking the ability to get merch, not just, I don't mean merch in the sense that sure, you go to conventions and you get a lot of people making like homemade stuff, right? Lots of doujinshis and lots of people getting commissions to do a Photoshop picture or something, or manga or something like that. There's lots of that stuff out there. That's fine. But they actually get something that's, a Japanese item thing, or, an actual promo item from an actual company or something. That's a lot rarer. That's a lot harder to get. So I thought, okay, well, I'm going to make some of that stuff available, to you guys. Okay? So, let's begin. So a lot of the stuff that I've done so far are like figures and CDs and whatnot. Okay, you can go back to episode 1 and 2 and check those out. So this episode's gonna be a lot on having to do with cards, okay? Because again, when I had my store, cards and that kind of stuff were really, really collectible and a really kind of fun item to have, okay? So the first type of cards that we are very, very familiar with is a deck of playing cards. So I've got, here you go, three different types of playing cards, okay? And I'll go through them with you, okay? So basically, let's do the first one here. This is a Nadia Secret of Blue Water card set, okay? So basically, you open it up, okay, and out comes a little deck of cards, okay? And as you see, it's a 52 card deck of cards, and it's all numbered, as different sort of playing card set there. And then on each card is a different picture, okay? So you can go through each of the different cards, and you get different pictures of different things from Nadia, all the different characters, different scenes, and that kind of stuff from Nadia, okay? So that's this particular one here. And again, the entire 52-card set is full of that kind of stuff, okay? So that's available for someone out there who really likes Nadia, okay? I also have one in a nice plastic case here. It's for My Goddess, okay? And you open up this one here like this. And again, one side is, your goddess family picture, right? And on the other side is, different pictures for all the different characters, and each is a different face is a different card. So face cards, aces and that kind of stuff. All in each different card has one of that kind of stuff. So again, your standard 52 card deck set of things is available for this set here. Okay. The third one that I have here is this one here. This is a Fushigi Yugi card deck set, okay? And when I pop open the box for this one, okay? Now this is a really nice set because it's hard to see on this thing, but as you can see, the face of the card, it actually is not like just a smoothy waxy card. There's actually where you see the gold part is actually, you know, there's a little bit of a feel to it, okay? So it's not that same. So it's got kind of a little bit of a texture on that, as you can see there. It's semi-reflective. If you can kind of, it's kind of hold it to the light there. You can see certain parts of it as I go through it. It's reflective. Okay, so it's kind of really cool kind of card here. But again, standard 52 card set here, that side, and if you flip to the other side, okay, 52 cards of all the different sort of pictures. So again, for fans of Fushigi Yugi, you can see there's different pictures on every single card, different sort of playing thing on every one there. So okay, so again, if you're a really big fan of Fushigi Yugi, this is a really kind of a cool thing to have. Not that you ever play poker or anything or blackjack with any of these things, but definitely this gives you a really nice collection of art pictures and that kind of stuff. And that's it. At the time when these things came out, these are the, this is like the really, a really valuable way in order to get a good variety of pictures, because again, the internet wasn't fast enough for you to get a lot of these pictures and that kind of stuff. So you have to understand that, a lot of times the only way you can get, pictures like this is you actually have to get a physical copy of the picture. You can't go over to the internet and download it because just the internet was just too slow. And they just didn't have high resolution of pictures for that kind of stuff. Okay. Okay, so the next collection I got is this sort of collection. It's a neat collection of cards. Okay, now one of the biggest companies that was out there was Pioneer / Anime Village. Okay, and they produced a lot of different really, really good animes. Okay. And again, but just due to the just the thing of the anime crash and everything like that, they never really never recovered. And virtually none of the companies actually ever recovered to any extent. So now, a lot of their promotional stuff is really hard to get. So I have here, this is a Christmas card, okay, from Paname. It's a Tenshimuyo one, and it's basically from all of us at it's hard to read that, from all of us at Pioneer Animation, okay. Is that, and inside the thing had a bunch of postcards, okay. So again, you could put a stamp on this and whatnot. But here you go. There's a Saber Marionette J again. Okay, we have one for Outlaw Stars. Okay, and these are all these the Anime Village postcards and that kind of stuff for them. Okay, this is one for Silent Mobius. Okay, the TV series there. We have one for Blue Submarine number 6. This is one of the really first, kind of half CG animes and that kind of stuff that was out there. It was really, really, really pretty good. And then, of course, I have one for Brain Powered, okay? So, again, it's a nice set of cards that that came out from Pioneer / Anime Village, which is really good there. So, again, this is one set for you, okay? Okay. Now I have another really sort of really big thing here. Okay, so this is a packet poster, a post up. Okay, and this is from okay, so I'll open it up. So again, it looks like an envelope, all right? So just flat, And it seals up at the very top here with an envelope. But when you're supposed to take it, is you cut it and you break it open, and then it folds out. And okay, it gives you instructions here, so it's kind of okay. So it tells you, you know, sort of the instructions how to build this thing. But I think it's kind of pretty obvious now. So you kind of open it up here. And he goes, you know, so it's, you know. Anyway, so there you go. So this is for the Ugly Beautiful World, okay? It's a big, huge kind of, you know, it's when you fold it all open and open it all up, okay? It makes a huge stand where you can actually prop the thing up and then actually stand it up, okay? And make a, you know, a poster stand out of this particular figure from that. And again, this is you know, the one of the big things that they're promoting in Megami magazine. So you go like that, okay? So this is the Beautiful Ugly World, shall we say, stand up, okay? The instructions, not that you actually really need it, but it's it's available there for you as well, okay? Now, the next big one that I got is I got a special set of cassette cards. Now, I know I did a bunch of cassette cards in the previous episode, and those were mostly anime things, but I stumbled across this one, and I totally forgot I had it. Okay. I have a collection of voice seiyu cards, okay? So, again, these are voice actors and that kind of stuff, and actresses. For different types of animes. So again, not only can you just to say, for example, make a tape mix of a particular, you know, anime songs and that kind of stuff. Well, let's say a tape mix of different seiyuu songs and that kind of stuff, because a lot of these seiyuus also sing and do all those things, like, you know, as in addition to doing voicing and that kind of stuff, right? So I got a bunch there. So again, I'll just kind of go through them really kind of quickly, and then I'll go over the ones that are really, like, you know, particularly famous. So as you see, you know, different sort of, you know, artist kind of information, and then they have a little sort of artist profile information as well as a track listing, so you know when the person was born and all this other stuff, right? So so there you go. That one, okay. All right, just kind of go through some of these really, really quickly, and I'll go over some of the really famous ones afterwards here, okay? So, there we go, kind of different sort of... Okay, now, I'll go over this one. A lot of you'll recognize her. She's, again, Megumi Hashibara, all right? So she's the one that does... Ranma in Ranma Half. She does Renge in Heavenward Shirado. She does Lina Inverse in Slayers. And, you know, she does a whole pile of albums. She's the number one seiyuu, you know, artist in that classification, because she's, like, got so many CDs and she does so many opening theme songs. You know, again, really, you know, really very popular character there. Okay, there's this one here. This is Michi Toazawa. She does Sailor Mars, she does Genie / she does Dana in Southern Cross, she does Manami's voice in Kimiko no Orange Road, she does Smire's voice in the Sakura Wars, and she does Alina's voice in Bubblegum Crisis, among some of the things that she does, okay? This one here, this is Rika Fukakami, okay? She does Sailor Venus's voice, all right? And she does Fran's voice in Final Fantasy XII. Helen's voice in Gundam V, and she has Myung's voice in Macross Plus, amongst other things that she does, okay? So again, this is her card. Here's another one. This is Kotono Mitsusushi, okay? She does Sailor Moon's voice, all right? She does also Misato's voice out of Neon Genesis Evangelion. She does Boa's voice in One Piece, Udemy, the really smart chick in GTO, she does Excel's voice in Excel Saga. So again, very famous amongst all the things that she does, okay? And I got one more card here. This is Kei Araki, okay? She does Chibiusa's voice, okay? She does Jacqueline's voice in 003. She does Minnie's voice in Gunsmith Cats. She does Miyaka's voice in Fushigi Yugi. And she does Sayaka's voice in Saint Tale, amongst other things that she does, okay? So this is a nice little collection of some very famous... seiyuus and stuff, okay? Now, I said that we sold a lot of collectible cards and stuff. When I ran the store, and I mean, you know, at the time, things like Pokemon, Yu-Gi-Oh, of course, Magic the Gathering, Sailor Moon cards, were all really, really big things. That people were really collecting off. So, but I got a few other ones that people also really gravitated towards, and I'm gonna make them available as well. So I have a set of here, Magical Knights Ray Earth cards, okay? And I got two sheets of there, so I'll put these together here. These are Magical Knights Ray Earth cards. Again, I used to hang them on a thing like on a nail or whatever, a clip like this, and then basically had them make accessible to people so that they could buy particular cards and that kind of stuff from that one. So again, so it's a set of Magical Knights Ray Earth cards. Now this is not a card, but I'll put this out because it's also Magical Knights Ray Earth. But I also got a Magical Knights Ray Earth notebook. Okay, so this book is really nice because it has this really nice picture of Magical Knights Ray Earth. You open it up and it makes a nice sort of long poster kind of thing on that. And the book is basically has lined paper and kind of stationery type paper. So if you want to write a letter or that kind of stuff, or memoir notes or something like that, you can write it on there. And it's got all ruled lines and that kind of stuff. So this is sort of a Magical Knights Ray Earth notebook. Okay. As I said, I sold a lot of cards and that kind of stuff when I was doing anime and that kind of stuff. And a lot of people came in looking for Sailor Moon, everything from Pokemon, a lot of them. I dabbled a little bit in the Magic of the Gathering, so I had binders and that kind of stuff, all that kind of stuff. But another one that was really, really popular was Dragon Ball. Okay, so I have here a fair number of Dragon Ball cards. So if you are interested in a sheet of Dragon Ball cards, say so, and I'll throw one in there for you. But I'll just quickly go over them. I won't really tell a number of them, but I mean, if you really want a particular card, you can sort of let me know. But I'll also kind of go over them. So here's a various number of Dragon Ball cards. And I'll try to get it so it doesn't sort of reflect here. So, so a sheet of there. There's two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, and 18. So again, if there's a particular sheet that you want, let me know by number. Or just it doesn't matter. Just pick one out of random. I'll pick one out of random. Okay. So again, we had lots of those things in the store all the time, and people are always would pour through them and pick out their favorite characters and all that kind of stuff. And it was a kind of a fun collectible thing that a lot of people did to help their collections. Okay. I have two other things I want to show you. And if you're interested in that, you can do ask for these ones. Okay. So. Obviously, once you go and you pick your favorite cards or whatever, some people would put them into card holding sheets like this, right? And then put it into a binder, a collectible binder type of thing. I mean, people use these for everything from baseball cards to hockey cards, football cards, anything like that. They'd use these kind of sheets for, right? But for those people who wanted something a little more special, they also made little card books, okay? So I have two of them here, okay? So if you're interested in that, I have one for Sailor Moon SS, okay? So again, when the Sailor Moon SS cards that came out, you could have, you know, it's a little booklet that sort of opens up, and it has places to put your cards into. Okay, so it's got a whole bunch of different pages and that kind of stuff to put your cards and that kind of stuff in. If you really wanted to write notes and stuff on the one side, you can do that on there. Not that you would. And okay, you can even, you know, put a little picture or whatever there, and you can fill in some information about yourself if you really wanted to. Not to deal with that, but anyway, and then of course the Mac pictures again. So that's a Sailor Moon S set, okay, for, you know, putting all your cards or whatever in there, okay. And I have also a similar version for Dragon Ball GT, okay. All right, so when you open, so you know, you kind of see that the card set there, okay. And then when you open it up, there's a, you know, good number of sheets and that kind of stuff where you put your Dragon Ball cards in, okay. And then, you know, that stuff. And again, also if you feel like you can put your information on it there, not that anyone would ever return it to you if you ever lost it, but, you know, that's the way it is. Anyway, so again, Dragon Ball GT card holder. Okay, so I hope that, you know, gives you some, you know, more good ideas and you know, makes you really excited about, you know, the stuff that's available. So what you want to do right now is you want to, you know, make your list, you know, maybe set your top four items, okay, and get ready to submit that in, because when I drop the episode for the to tell you all about how to do all the shipping and all that kind of stuff, that's when you want to be able to you know, go down and put your dibs into where you want to, okay? So don't do it on this one. You do it on the next one when you put the comments down on that one. And again, anytime in the video, please click your like and click subscribe. And again, if you haven't hit subscribe yet, it's probably a good idea to do so. If you ever think of doing that, or, you know, if you're planning to donate or whatever, you can also do that in the next episode as well. That will help your position in the line if you want to try to do it all at once, okay? But again, next episode, we'll get into all that, okay? So I hope you got your excitement going here, and we'll see you in the next episode when we get all that, okay? So until then, I will see you again.